yard. Do you have any interest in coming to the game?
Before we start the third, folks, here's a reminder, Thursday and Friday morning, join ESPNU for NBA Draft Combine News. Brian Russillo and a panel of experts breaking down the strengths and weaknesses of some of the top players of the NBA Draft Combine, including Kyrie Irving, Jimmer Fredette, and Kemba Walker. It's the NBA Draft Combine, Thursday and Friday, 10 a.m. Eastern. Virginia stays in that pressure defense. Lipstein sends it to the goal, and it's deflected away. Excellent hustle by Chris Clements.
Virginia took the chances, but I'll tell you, Bucknell was prepared for the situation. They knew exactly what they wanted to do, just missed the shot.
They made it look so easy, didn't they? I mean, Coach Federaco was brilliant right there. Just throw it to the guy who's covered by the goal.
Briggs marching in. Feeney, as he's done twice today, anticipates that pass beautifully to make the intercept, denying Bucknell a chance for his sixth goal. Here's where we are. Less than 3 minutes to go in the fourth. NCAA Men's Lacrosse Championship presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Joe Beninati, Jamie Monroe. Long fling towards the empty net goes wide. Who's got the Virginia ball?
Virginia was in a 10-man ride. Part of what they were going over in that timeout that Coach was talking about was, what do we do if we don't get it? We lose it. We're going into a 10-man ride.
In tight. All the way in the crease. Stanwyck scores. The lead and the deficit now for Virginia. One.
Well, that was a high risk of play in that they shot the ball the length of the field, but it was a planned play in that Bucknell thought they'd have it backed up. And to tell you the truth,
watch Stanwyck go hard at his man. If you want to put a long pole in a tough spot, run right at him. In this case, right at the head of his stick, and all of a sudden, it's like you're playing with a short pole. Stanwyck runs right by his man. So early in the possession, Bucknell was not ready to help.
Steele Stanwyck, in his NCAA tournament career, 7 games, has 34 points.
Is that any good?
12-11 Bucknell. Bison win the draw. Clark doing the honors. Running for cover here, taking it all the way to the crease. He sends it wide. It'll be Bucknell ball with 2:19 to go. Bailey working to the outside on the flip. Hands it off for the short stick D midfielder. That's Jason Forite. Well up on the play.
So
2:05 to go in the fourth.
Watch Bucknell run a four-man rotation behind the net.
Bucknell did not need to shoot the ball.
Stanwyck scores! Steele Stanwyck ties it at 12. A brilliant lacrosse game unfolding, winding to the finish in Charlottesville on ESPNU.
They're going to get it to him.
Everybody back to 6-on-6 now with 30 seconds to go. Briggs giving the traffic directions. They clear it out for him. Briggs going to the goal against Clark. Feed backside. Just punched wide by Matt White. Time ticking away. 24 seconds to go in the fourth. A wild scramble for the loose ball. White picks it up. Over the top. Stanwyck finds Bucklett again. Knocked aside. Great defense by John Collette. Nethemer is there for Bucknell. Jason Nethemer lobs it on back. 2 seconds now, Juan. Feeney chips at the full length of the field, and this game requires overtime.
We go into overtime.
Tied up at 12 in the NCAA Lacrosse Championship. Ryan McDermott will take the draw against Jake Clark, and it is Clark who wins it for Bucknell. First possession, 6-on-6. Chase Bailey on the hop. Charlie Streep has been cramping since the late third quarter and has not been in the lineup, although he's jogging out onto the field now. Streep has the ball.
I like this on Bucknell's part. They did not call a timeout when they came up with the ball. They're forcing Virginia to play defense with the guys that are on the field. I like that strategy.
Streep will clear it out. Chris Clements is right there with him, the long stick midfielder. We are in overtime on ESPNU. Bucknell threatening to pull off a major upset. Take out the 7th seed should they score here. Danilishin for Bailey in no hurry. Marked by Scott McWilliams. It's Eisenreich, who has displayed a beautiful shooting stroke today. Looks for the split dodge, ran right into the cross of the short stick defender, Blake Riley. Back come the Cavaliers, their first chance to go for the win.
That's an example of a guy who's played a lot on field turf, where you can lean back a little bit in your cuts and you don't go down. On this grass, Coach Starz was talking about it a little bit early, like you'll slip if you don't have your feet right underneath you.
Huffner takes Stanwyck, works around the screen, throws it on back. White stoops! He scores! Matt White ends the day for Virginia. They race off to round two.
Heartbreaking for Coach Fedorovka. Pure joy for the Cavs. A two-man game behind the net. Bucknell always switches. And White sets the pick, slips, finds the ball, late rotation, beautiful finish. Virginia's going to be going to the next round.
And White was very strong in making his shot.
Pure joy for the Cavs. A two-man game behind the net. Bucknell always switches. And White sets the pick, slips, finds the ball. Late rotation. The defender on the ball doesn't switch as early as he needed to. And they didn't get the rotation down the backside. White throws it around the goal.